Hello and welcome back, Empire of the Sun, Walking on a Dream. Let's watch. This looks like some sort of temple. You got a guy walking towards us. Walking on a dream. 14 years ago, so what's that? 2010. This is right after the success of MGMT, the duo, synth-pop duo. Talking to myself. Will I see again? Are they in China? We are always running for the thrill of it, always pushing up the hill, searching for the thrill of it. All along, we are calling out now. I guess one thing interesting that I noticed right away is that these all seem to be solo, or what's it called? Steady shots, so no moving camera, so you could film this by yourself. Oh, that shot's moving a little bit. Set up a tripod and film this. I did a little research into this song. I think, they spent a long time recording it. And, when it finally got popular, there really was no performance aspect to their whole collective. But then they had to create it. So, I think they do perform the song. This is something you hear when you're shopping at Target or wherever you're at. Dress up in these costumes and everything. So this has got 222 million. To me, the recording itself sounds like pretty lo-fi. It sounds like they could have recorded it on a Firepod, if anyone knows what that is. Alright, let's try and follow this plot line in this video. Looking into a crystal ball or at the temple. Alright, I'm not making any sense of it. So this guy's got the whole, band leader jacket on. Or is this guy's got some sort of, I'm guessing, traditional Chinese temple master outfit on? We got a little animation, flying birds. Oh, that's like the guy from Mortal Kombat. He's twirling sticks around. You know, this is kind of like that band Phoenix, too, and their hit album Wolfgang Amadeus Phoenix. What's the... 1788? Is that the hit song? This kind of sounds like Phoenix, is what I'm trying to say. This is, slightly different. Alright, I gotta look up some info about this, because I don't know. I'm gonna guess Shanghai. The video pretty much didn't make any sense. It was just a sizzle roll. Sizzle reel. Alright, let's see if I can look up info about this song real quick. You mind if I tell you my favorite Matt Damon story just real quick? Alright, let's look. Empire of the Sun. Empire of the Sun. I was just talking in my previous video about how I read a whole magazine about Guns N' Roses, and I still, it was so poorly written that I couldn't even, put the pieces together. Happens a lot, more than you'd think. you go to read like a newspaper article, and you could say, oh, like I'm smart because I'm reading the paper. Meanwhile, like the article's written so poorly, you can't even get anything out of it. All right, here we go. Formed in 2007, Luke Steele and Nick Littlemore, they're from Australia. Debut album was in 2008, international success and a double platinum in Australia and gold in the UK, Walking on a Dream. Number 10 on the Australian singles chart, 64 on the UK chart, so not that big. Then they did another album called Ice on the Dune. So they won 11 Australian Music Awards. Let's see. They met in 2000 after being introduced by an A&R guy at a bar in Sydney. They were both signed to EMI and had already been working on different projects. This is like a story from times that have passed us, in my opinion. Because the label is not as important as it once was. So they collaborated, blah, blah, blah. Alright, so they recorded it in 2007. Alright, so, and then, as I mentioned before, like, they had a hit song, but they really were just, like, studio guys, so then they had to, this is what the quote is. Success brought an audience to which we felt a duty to be good to them. So I'm guessing, like, because they had success, then they felt the need to create the performance aspect, whatever. Anyway, I heard that song, and what happens quite frequently is that I will hear something in a gas station or store, and I won't know what it is, and I stubbornly have refused to download the Shazam or Kazam, whatever, where you sing into the phone and it tells you what it is. I can remember that. That's been out for a long time. That's probably been out for over 10 years, and I just refuse to download it. And now there's even a TV show every night hosted by Kelly Osbourne and Nick Cannon where it's like Shazam. But I do my own version of Shazam, which is I try to listen closely enough to get some of the lyrics, then I type them into the little notepad on my phone, and then from there I will look up the lyrics online. It's pretty easy to find it that way too. Anyway, I'll give that video a solid... That reminded me of like one of these 90s videos where it's just like slow-mo shots where it's a complicated set design. Not much to it. There wasn't a narrative arc or anything. Probably was pretty high budget though, and it was a location shoot. So I'll give the video a 7.8. And I think the song... You gotta score the song pretty highly because it's fun to listen to. And they really hit that pocket of, I don't even know what you'd call that. It's right in that MGMT, what's their album called? Their first album, Oracular Spectacular. It's right in that zone. And then there was like subsequent different acts that tried to cash in on the wave of that. But it seems like they were just like coincidentally happening at the same time. But there was acts that tried to cash in on that, the whole thing. Yeah, so the song to me gets like an 8, I guess. Like I said before, it kind of sounds like shit, like they recorded it on like crappy gear, but I guess it goes to show it doesn't really matter what it sounds like as long as the song's good. Anyway, Empire of the Sun. If you enjoyed the reaction, hit the like button, comment, subscribe, thumbs up, and I'll see you next time. Bye!